A 41-year-old man has been charged with murder over a fatal stabbing in Sydney. Police were called to reports of a dispute at a building site in the city's west. They found a 54-year-old man suffering critical injuries. He died at the scene. His alleged attacker surrendered to police.
There were multiple stab wounds. We haven't established a motive as yet, but we are looking into different motives.
The man will face a Sydney court tomorrow. A Queensland court has heard graphic details of the night a police officer was killed. Gold Coast officer Damien Leading was killed 2 years ago during a robbery at a tavern. A Supreme Court trial has heard the 35-year-old fired 3 shots before his gun jammed. He was then fatally shot at close range. A 41-year-old man and a 39-year-old woman have pleaded not guilty to murder, but guilty to armed robbery with violence. Security cameras have captured a violent street brawl in Adelaide. Police say they were called to a domestic dispute involving a mother and her baby. It then descended into a street fight, even where police officers were injured. One was slashed on the cheek, another bitten on the arm. 3 men were arrested and have been charged with aggravated assault. 2 foreign journalists have been taken to the police station on Christmas Island after arriving on an asylum seeker boat from Indonesia. The American journalist and Dutch photographer had Australian visas and were cleared by immigration on arrival. It's believed they work for the New York Times. The pair has been described as badly sunburnt. An Indian-born doctor jailed for molesting a patient faces deportation. Suhail Durrani was convicted of sexually assaulting a 19-year-old woman at a Perth hospital 2 years ago. He was released on parole in February, but on the eve of the election on Friday, the immigration minister overruled the decision and his visa was cancelled. Dr. Durrani is now in detention and the only option is a federal court appeal. 2 hikers missing in country Victoria have been reunited with emotional family members. 77-year-old Ruth Binder and her son Sam had been missing for a day after failing to return from a trek in the Alpine National Park.
Oh, my arms are a bit sore and my legs are a bit sore and, you know, just old age, that's it. But no problems, there's no problems really.
Wild weather forced the pair to change their original route, delaying their return. A main highway in central Queensland has reopened after a fiery tanker explosion. The tanker was carrying more than 100,000 litres of fuel when it collided with a car and a semi-trailer west of Mackay. 4 people were taken to hospital. The entire area was locked down as the explosion sparked a grass fire. The flames burned for several hours and emergency crews worked all day to restore power lines and clear the wreckage. A group of Hoon drivers has led police on a wild chase on the Gold Coast. Police say at least one driver lost control while doing burnouts and crashed. The group then tried to lift the car off the wall, and when that failed, they fled on foot. A land, air and sea search was launched by police. The 3 men were arrested a short time later. Reckless teenagers are putting their lives at risk by playing chicken with trains. This group of teens has been caught on camera jumping between platforms at a station in Wollongong on the New South Wales south coast. City Trains say the dangerous behaviour is becoming more common, with hundreds of people trespassing on the tracks each month. Business and retail groups are hopeful of a post-election boost. Economists say a new stable government and record low interest rates should see a spike in spending.
Traditionally, what we know is that after an election, when we get a clear result, we see an uptick in sales.
If you start to get a lift in sales, then you are going to employ more people and it's going to have the domino effect.
Business is also buoyed by Tony Abbott's pledge to scrap the carbon and mining taxes. And a health warning has been issued for Sydneysiders, with pollen levels expected to reach extreme tomorrow. A combination of pollen smoke and higher temperatures have become extremely dangerous for asthmatics.
You can say, well, I'm walking to the office but I'm puffing. And that is what they should respond to, that danger sign, because it's only going to get worse.
The air quality is expected to improve by the end of the week. A quick look at the weather across the country tonight. It's currently 22 degrees in Townsville, 19 in Brisbane, 20 at the moment in Sydney and Melbourne, 15 degrees in Adelaide and 18 in Perth.